You're good if you want to come on this side. You're good, you're good.
Thank you. No worries. Raven Chacon is a composer, performer, and installation artist from Fort Defiance, Navajo Nation. As a solo artist, Chacon has exhibited, performed, and had works performed at LACMA, the Renaissance site in Chicago, San Francisco, the Carnegie Festival, REDCAT in LA, Vancouver Art Gallery, the ICA Miami in Berlin, Borealis Festival, site Santa Fe, Chaco Canyon, the list goes on and on for a long time. But it ends with the Kennedy Center. As a member of Postcommodity from 2019 to 2018, he co-created artworks presented at the Whitney Biennial, Documenta 14, Carnegie International 57, as well as the 2-mile-long land art installation called Repellent Fence. That work existed between over the US-Mexico border, and it rejoined native lands. that the border had, breached, right, or interrupted. As a recording artist, over a span of 22 years, Chacon has appeared on more than 80 releases on various national and international labels. His 2020 manifest, Destiny from Opera, Sweet Land, composed with Byun, received critical acclaim from the LA Times, the New York Times, the New Yorker, and was named 2021 Opera of the Year by the Music Critic Associations of North America. Since 2004, he has mentored over 300 high school Native composers in the writing of new string quartets for the Native American Composer Apprenticeship Project. Chacon is a recipient of the United States Arts Fellowship in Music, the Creative Capital Award in Visual Arts, the Native Arts and Culture Foundation Arts Fellowship, the American Academy's Berlin Prize for Music Composition, the MIMA Center Reconnect Award, the Pulitzer Prize in Music, which he got this year, first Native American artist to ever get and in 2022, he will serve as a Pew Fellow in Residence. His solo artworks are in the collection of the Whitney Museum, the Smithsonian, LA County Museum, Getty Research Institute, the University of Mexico Art Museum, and various private collections. So I hand over to Raven, and he can maybe discuss the structure of this.
Thank you all for coming and hanging out. I was invited to come this week to do some kind of seminar, workshop, whatever. They said a performance too. So that's a lot of stuff to do in 3 days. But I've been, you know, a lot of my work is scores, working with either like classical music scores, writing for the opera or the symphony folks, or it's making more kind of text or graphic notation kind of documents. And so for this workshop, we gathered under an idea of just making scores that were one page, whatever that meant, whether it's something that's drawn, whether it's something more instructional with text. Participants came together just a couple days ago, and we thought of some ideas, and some of the participants already had scores they've been working on. So that's what we saw tonight. None of these were my scores. These were written by those that were in the workshop and developed by other participants. So everybody who was involved in some way, definitely led to what you saw tonight. And some of these weren't performed until you just saw them just now. So, welcome thoughts and interpretation of any of that. And so I'm going to introduce everybody who was involved in this, but want to also credit the ones who started these scores. So the first one was Kristen Meyer, the one we saw outside, with a piece called Oculus. And in that piece, we had Paolo Rodriguez. We had Sonia. Was Sonia on that one? No, Sonia helped us get up to the next level. We had Emily Milgram.
Basically choreography, and the movement was dictated by activating
Sonia Tapia helped guide us upstairs, and then we saw a piece by Domingo Castillo. And this was this one right here. It's called Artifacts, and it was performed by Emily. And so I'll have Diego talk a bit about that one. That was the Beyonce.
Hi. So it was a way of creating a generative work that every day, ongoing forever, it'll always be a different song because it's based on an equation where you just add up the days, and if it lands on a 10, you add 10 more years, and you subtract that number by today's like year, and then you find a year. So this year landed on like August, what, today's 18? August 18, 2003, the number one song in America was Beyonce's. And yeah, so like any day kind of like generates a different song, and the composition's exactly laid out the same. You let the song play out for 45 seconds, then you start a 32-bar loop, and then after each iteration of the loop, you slow it down by 10%, and then you increase the reverb by 10% until you reach zero. And then the last cycle is just like a slow, like the performer is allowed to kind of like either cut it or extend it at that point.
Ongoing or serving as interludes between the pieces or interrupting pieces. There were two different compositions. One of them was by Juan Moreno, and that was the one back here with the percussion. We can talk about that.
It's what you saw, basically. Back there is the score. Somewhere on the floor, you can take them if you want. Basically, I played drums, and I was in this workshop with Raven, and we went through his scores, which were kind of like puzzles, and had to do a lot with like autobiography of performers. And so I was like, damn, how am I going to make a score like this? So I just kind of thought about it as a puzzle, and I thought about like that anybody with musical knowledge can read a tab, could play if they had the time to dedicate to it, with the top line, but I just wrote all the steps it took for me to do it. So it's like a score of like probably more than a decade. If you want to do that through the steps I took, and that's just how I did it. But you don't have to do it that way. So yeah, that's fun. And this is my group right here to help with the claps, and so did all of you. So thank you.
And the full title of your piece.
Oh, it's called For Two Creolizing Hands.
So, Walking Spell was an old score that I did back in 2010, and it was a collaboration with the choreographer Ana Mendez, and we premiered it at the Miami Art Museum, and it was a 4-hour performance, and it was kind of what you saw here with the walking back and forth. It was three performers instead of two, and I thought, you know, we're working with graphic scores in this workshop, I might as well, you know, revive this old score and kind of give it new life with new performers, and some new instrumentation. So yeah, that's what you saw, Walking Spell.
And that's what's on the program. There was another piece, I don't know if anybody heard it, there was another participant, Christian Bijou, was called, he's watching the stream and he's calling people on their phone. Interrupting the performance. Sometimes it was on vibrate, some people had their phone off vibrate. If you heard a phone on the ring or buzz, that was Christian. And the last piece was Monica Mesa with The Land of the Three Dictators.
So the last piece was called Composition for Three Dictators in the Land of the Free. So the idea of having three different experimental musicians dictating what people's movements could be based on high tones, mid tones, or low tones. But it's more of a it's more of a commentary on politics and how nothing truly makes sense. So do we follow the rules? If there's a high tone, do we actually clap or do we stomp our feet? But that was the whole idea behind this, realizing whether people would follow rules or they would just go against the rules. And it was an interesting social experiment.
Really?
Sorry. Yeah. Within the dictators, there were overlapping notes. And then maybe one was playing a low note, and then another one was playing a mid tone, and then what do you do when it comes to that? So that was what the piece was about.
So thank you. I don't know if there's any questions from anybody.
Music from all around the world on cassette and vinyl this was all of the releases from last year. There were 16 releases in 2021, and we're planning tons more for 2022. Noir Edge.
Composed narrative throughout all of these, or theme, but that's something that I noticed just after right now.